this from ever happening again to protect our country.
Your select committee just told Steve Bannon once again that he must comply with the subpoena or face possible criminal contempt charges, that he had until 6 p.m., half an hour ago, to submit a written response if he feels there are any other issues. As far as you know, did he respond?
So far as I'm aware, he did not. At least I've not been advised by staff that he has. His claim of executive privilege is just really a stretch. First, he was not even an employee of the White House or the federal government, and so would not ordinarily be covered by any executive privilege claim. Further, even if that weren't the case, we want to talk to him about conversations he had, the plot that he may have helped hatch with other people, with organizers in the political arena, with political figures, both in the Congress and in state legislatures. That has nothing to do with his communications with the former president. And you can't just say, well, I'm not coming in. The law requires, when a subpoena has been duly issued, as this one was, to come in and make your case, state your case about why you think you are excused from telling the truth. He didn't even do that. So we feel this is behavior is outrageous, outrageous behavior on the part of Mr. Bannon. We will have a discussion tomorrow night, take a vote on whether to refer this to the Department of Justice for criminal prosecution. If the vote is positive, it then goes to the floor of the House. And if that vote is positive, it will then be referred to DOJ. And the statute says that the U.S. attorney shall present the matter to a sitting grand jury.
Representative Zoe Lofgren, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I want to get some more.